Hello everyone, and welcome to probably the first voiceover of an Armored Warfare replay I've done in a while. This one I'm going to title "How to Utterly Fuck Up a Game" or something along those lines, as I fucked this one up. Usually with YouTubers or stuff, you'll see games of "Yeah, I did everything right, I'm amazing." With this, I'm going to say I had some bad luck happen to me, but I lost this game due to my actions. And in many cases, my actions alone. So I'm in a T64 on a tier, in a roughly even tier spread, bunch of tier fives, tier fours, and tier threes on the narrows. So the T64A is a lot of people don't like it. It has a, as you can see, a 9.26 second reload, a long aiming time. It's essentially a worse T72 in every way, except for the fact that it's slightly faster, it looks better, and it has ERA plates. That's right, it has ERA plates. This has the longest reload of any Tier 5 MBT shell. So, the first thing I do is that I'm going to go hold down on this map. Alright? Now, I was feeling pretty confident in this time. Too confident, actually. While this thing can hold down, initially I wanted to plaster this chieftain because, in my view, chieftains are free kills. I also have a Type 62 come up, and of course, these guys can't pen my turret. So, the artillery takes 174 off of me, and the artillery is going to be quite important in this game, for reasons you'll probably see later. So there's still a chieftain over there, and I'm going to slap that ELC 90 for 403 damage. Right. So, but the thing about the artillery is what's really annoying is the artillery just takes all the ERA off in one shot, kind of killing all that passive protection. And of course, me still thinking a chieftain is a free kill, I continue to ignore it. Then I fuck up by, like not aiming properly. I aim at the turret instead of the mantle, and of course the chieftain has a longer reload than I do. But you know what? I do something stupid and something a lot of people do a lot, which is continuing to trade with people. And I know that I can trade with this person. I'm doubtlessly the better player, but I am not sure of my team's performance in this game. Why am I trading with this chieftain? You could argue that at that time I was like, hang on. Like, why is a Type 59 and a WZ just sitting there? Because right now they're going in a head-on fight with possibly the tank with the best turret armor of any light tank in the game, which is Leopard 185, which has amazing turret armor. So these people shooting in the turret armor is absolutely ridiculous, and they'll go, I get another bounce on the chieftain, and I'm down to 514 health. And at this point, I was raging at this WZ because this moron just wanted to sit there and trade shots for a tank he won't be able to pen, and the tank won't be able to pen him either. In all honesty, that WZ should have been up here with me. He would have had the he would have had the gun depression to be able to aim at that chieftain, but as of such, all of this damage taken so far has actually been my fault, because I continue to be stubborn, I continue to hold this ridge line, and I thought that my team would help me, but it turns out that it would have never happened, and now I'm on perilously low health. But still, in many cases, I'm probably the best player in this match, and I should carry my team. So I decide, okay, fuck it. So, although I have a longer reload time and the chieftain has better damage than me, I have better weak spots than a chieftain does. He has to aim at my lower plate. I can aim at his turret ring. I can aim at his lower glacis, which is huge. I have all the advantages over a chieftain as long as I play well, and I wasn't doing that at the start. I was continuing to trade with him instead of doing peekaboo, which is what I'm doing now, which is careful positioning, careful maneuvering, and holding the ridge. And of course, these people in my team still haven't come up here. And now, while that Leopard 185 over there died, it took way too long for him to die. So, at this moment, I'm kind of annoyed. Well, I say kind of, I'm very annoyed. This person in the WZ on full health has just fucking sat there and done nothing. Well, he's fired at a few people, but apart from that, he's done nothing. And then there's me just continuing to go around the corner and everything. I want to kill that dragoon really badly. And I bounce on the chieftain. This is a problem with me. I fire before it's fully aimed. And as you can see, that's a mistake right there, because this is a chieftain. I don't have the incredible aiming time that a lot that all of the other tier 5 MBTs have. I have a slow aiming time. I have a slow reload. I need to make these shots count at the moment. I'm not making them count at all. And what the actual fuck is that AMX-10P deciding to do? I don't know how that bounced in the turret ring, but you know what? I have no idea. I really don't know. If I'd have hit that chieftain would have been dead, and maybe the game would have gone a little bit differently. But for now, I'm entirely confident that I can just whittle this guy down by shooting his cupola, and that artillery hits me in the gun. Now, this tank's aim time is already bad, and I'm just making it worse at this point. And this artillery fucking shoots at me again. Now I'm 159 HP. I should not be here. I should back up. And yet I'm not backing up. I'm letting this artillery shoot me. And now I think I've used my repair kit. I'm not sure. So anyway, someone else kills a BMP-2, but you know what? I don't care at this rate. I should have done this a long time ago. I should have just gone round and let the other people deal with it. Now, I thought I was going to be able to hit this BMP-1 there. Can I hit it? I think I do. Nope, miss. Another killed another two of our team. So now it's a pretty perilous situation for us. But you know what? I can still carry this. I've no idea what this thing fire is doing, and now there's people shooting at me. Regardless of what tank it is, even if it's just a crappy tier 3, they only need to get lucky with high explosive a few times. That's it. And while I would be confident in Russian AFVs, with the way the stupid artillery works right now, and the ability to just blow all your AO off, or your ERA off, what's the point? I was like, shit, there's a Type 59. So of course I back up, and to be honest, that guy should have been rushing me at this point, but alas not. So I know he's fired, I have a lot of time in the world, and we do a cheeky drive-by. Boom. 2,000 damage, one kill. And you could say, yeah, the WZ has done more at this point, has he? Has he just sit there and farmed his team's damage while they died for him, or has he actually tried to be an active participant in this battle like me? I kill the T-62. Other T-62 goes down. And to be honest, I don't know how this WZ has lost all this HP. He's like the most well-armored tank at tier 5. How is he losing that much? You know, it don't matter at this point. Now, at this moment in time, I can't repair my stuff. I have a bad aim time. I have not enough HP. In this game, I am physically unable to carry because all it takes is one hit from just about anything. Even a hit from that Type 59 could kill me. And I don't know what the hell this WZ was doing. What are you doing, dude? But yeah, I'm like, oh shit, now I have to kill him. So now I'm basically shitting bricks at this point. Now I have to, in order to engage the Leopard 1A5 from a hold down position, I have to rush him. I have to get under his gun. Now that artillery is going to be aiming at me, and I bounce on him. So I decide to wait until I get spotted, or until he fires. And I told you, I'm shitting bricks at this point. I don't want to get hit by the artillery because the artillery will kill me. And I don't want to get hit by the Leopard 1A5 because all he could do right now is fire explosive and kill me. But you know what? I was thinking at this point, I need to get under his gun. I had the plan of action. That's what you need to do in situations like this. You need to mentally develop a plan on how to take on your opponent. You need to figure out how you're going to do it, and then you need to gun for it. For, this is going to sound accurate, but for good players, I guess I'm a good player by most statistics, we think of a plan, we stick to it, and we do it without hesitation. And I'm doing this plan without hesitation. Right, I'm under his gun now. His, all of that gun depression and hold down advantage right now of his is gone, because in order to shoot me, he has to peek up or expose a part of his tank. At the moment, this guy has critically fucked up. You see, he's angled his tank. T-64 does not care about hull armor. So Leopard 1, he chose himself a good position. Did he screw up? Yes. He angled his tank, he exposed his hull armor, and instead of, and in order to correctly do that, he should have backed off and made me go up the hill after him. So the artillery would have been able to have shots on me. Now I'm loading heat. So, I have basically horrific aim time right now. I have low enough HP. Can I carry this? And the short answer is, unless I get lucky, no. We know the Type 59 is AFK. At this point, I was, like I said, literally shitting bricks that I didn't even know he was, even though it says right there in the counter on the top right. So, yeah. At the moment, I was like, can I kill the artillery? I want to kill the artillery, but now I'm like, shit, now the artillery knows where I am. I got to get away from him. I got to get away. And now I'm fumbling at this point. I don't have a plan on what I'm doing. I'm like, I want to kill this Type 59. Oh, shit, the artillery's there. Now I want to kill the artillery. But if I don't kill the Type 59, then the artillery's going to know where I am. But if I kill the Type 59, then the artillery will still know where I am. How did that miss? I don't know. You see, mistake being made. And now the artillery has hit me again for 70 damage. Okay, let's just look at this through sniper aim. And at this point, I'm like, oh, miss. Shit. Go under his gun and make it so he can't hit you. Make it so he can't hit you. Okay, I hit him. Okay, I can do this. And now, the fuck up happens. Right here. Miss. And I didn't fully aim at all. Although, to be honest, that artillery probably had the biggest aim circle in the world and was lucky. I was raging at this point. And you know what? I would implore you to watch that video again and learn from my mistakes. I screwed up. Don't screw up like I did. Don't get into that mindset where you're like, I have to kill, because you will start making mistakes. You will start fumbling. You will start trading with that chieftain like I did. You will not fully aim on that artillery like I did. You will not kill that Type 59 at the start like I did. You will sit there on that hill and crap yourself as you lose tons of HP like I did. Anyway, that's a fun video, isn't it? I just wanted to show you all, like, how easy it is just to screw things up. And you know what? In my opinion, that's better than, like, the best carry game you'll ever see, because I made a mistake. So, see you all for tomorrow's livestream, I guess. Bye!